Still in the healthy sector, Mbarara Regional Referral Hospital has started preparing health centres for and other health centres to handle the increasing cases of COVID-19 in the areas. Dr. Celestine Bajire, the hospital director, said the move is intended to decongest Mbarara Hospital, which is currently overwhelmed by the cases. Here is the report.
Barije and his team have so far visited Itojo Hospital, Chitagata Hospital and Rubirizi Health Center for to reassure health workers and to prepare them to handle COVID-19 and also to identify some of the challenges they are facing so that they are not overwhelmed by numbers.
The program apparently we are moving here and there is that we get prepared in this region. COVID is everywhere. If we remain in Mbarara without coming here, we are assuring our health workers here to make sure that they are prepared to handle COVID. Then we shall be overwhelmed the other side. But also to identify some of these challenges like ambulance and other things which I think we can handle quickly so that we are not overwhelmed by this COVID-19 by just remaining the other side. But in addition, the Ministry of Health mandated regional referral hospitals to supervise these areas so that with our big technical team we can find out gaps and some of the challenges which we can easily address at a national level.
At Rirezi Health Center 4, Barije challenged politicians in the area, especially the members of parliament, to agitate for a bigger hospital in their area that would handle the increasing population. Rirezi accommodates so many tourists and needs better facilities.
The other thing is that this hospital, this health center is too small. I'm calling upon the politicians here that it is high time we agitated for a hospital here, because this area, the area has tourists down here, a lot of hotels, it has a lot of big population. In case anything happens to these tourists, really this health center is just not enough to handle that. So the hospital, they have no ambulance. We are going to follow up these issues. We need an ambulance, especially even during these areas of COVID. In case someone gets so bad, we will need transporting to Mbarara, but we need an appropriate ambulance system.
Dr. Ida Nanchinga, in charge of Rugazi Health Center 4, said they are still facing a number of challenges, including limited number of health workers and infrastructure.
As we have, the first one is with staffing. According to the government structure, we are staffed well, but when you look at the real patients that come, the numbers that come in, they're overwhelming. So it appears as if we are understaffed. Then also, we have now a challenge of infrastructure. The buildings we have in place are very small compared to the number of patients who come in. So there is a lot of congestion in the different departments.
For this service in Rugazi, but as the Rugazi Health Center for, the midwives are very few. So we ask the government to recruit more midwives so that the capacity is built and the community is properly served.
Meanwhile, residents in Rubirizi District want district leadership to come up strongly and put heavy fines on whoever contravened the sent SOPs. These said the district can also use this as a source of revenue.
So the leadership should come out strongly on this. Put fines on whoever contravened the guidelines and the preventive measures of COVID. For example, should you be found without a mask, it should be clear that you'll pay a given amount of money. People's problem is money. People fear to pay money than they fear the pandemic.
Mbarara Hospital has so far looked after 780 patients of COVID-19. Of these, they admitted 321 and some were handled under the home care-based system. And of these, 56 died. This story was compiled by Abdul Karim Sengendo for the news in Rubirizi District.